Welcome to Talk Tiger. Today we are with Dr. Atreyi, and she's going to talk to us about how to manage diabetes. Most of these tips can be used by everybody, but I would request you all to look at your specific reports and contact her so that she can give you customized diet plans. So Atreyi has some 6 tips today to share with you, and here you go. Okay, Atreyi, go on.
So I do specialize with working with rice. Okay. Anybody who comes to me, they come mentally prepared that ye rice khilane wali hai. Okay. And people with diabetes come to me because they want to eat rice. Okay. And since our palate is rice-based palate in India, most of the part of India eats a lot of rice. It becomes a lot challenging if you suddenly learn you have diabetes and chapati is something which is advised in general. So I practically want to talk about how to eat rice, okay, with diabetes. Okay. Now, first thing, if you have diabetes, timing is the key. Indian food pattern works in terms of timing, okay. Since we are not big on proportion control as a diet, and our in general pattern in India is a carbohydrate based pattern, okay. So, timing becomes a major thing. See, in our ancient Indians, we used to have breakfast at 6 in the morning, finish dinner by 5:30. There was no diabetes because Indian palate would work well. If you are having 5:30 dinner, you quietly eat rice, it works. But if at modern age, if you are having diabetes, you need to have your breakfast by 8:30 or finish it max by 9. If you are having a breakfast post 9, you will see a shoot up in the sugar levels next day morning. Okay, empty stomach, you see. Yeah. So so timing is the key in diabetes. You have to have breakfast by 8:39, max 9. But if you are having breakfast by 9:30, the readings of glucose will be different next day. Okay. 15-15 minute mein to readings badal jate. So if you have breakfast at 9 o'clock, you will see your sugar level is 120 next day morning. If you have breakfast by 9 in the morning, it will be 110. If you have it at 8:30, it will be 108. Okay, so it will vary. Lunch by 1:30. If you are finishing lunch by 2 o'clock, your sugar level is bound to be 200-250. If you are looking to bring down your glucose level below 250, please have your lunch by 1:30 in the afternoon, max by 1:30. Okay. Lastly, if you want to have dinner, finish it max by 7:38, even if you have chapati. If you have diabetes, you can't afford to have dinner past 7:45.
Wow.
Okay. If you are doing beyond 7:45 as dinner, it can be like once in a blue moon, like you have a meeting or something or the other. Then next day, please check your sugar readings. Like since I work with people and try to bring their HbA1c down on an average, my requirement is more timing than actually what they're eating. Okay. So if somebody has an average dinner, has diabetes and has dinner at 9 o'clock, zindagi mein 200 niche kabhi nahi aayega. Okay. An average HbA1c will be 6.1, 6.2, 6.5. Okay. If you want to bring it below the range of 6, you need to have breakfast by 9 in the morning, lunch by 1:30, and dinner by 7:30 in the evening. Two. A lot of people who have diabetes, they do drink a lot of Kerala juice, okay, or combination of Kerala juices. Please avoid drinking Kerala juice which is packed and sold in the market, or Kerala tablets, okay. Prefer to drink fresh Kerala juice, okay. So if you can't determine how much Kerala for one person, this is your measurement, okay. Small finger is the maximum amount of Kerala you can have. Okay. So nowadays in Bangalore, we get this natty Kerala's, this tiny size of Kerala's. That if you are taking one full Kerala of that would do, or this is your size. You have to blend the Kerala and drink it off. Okay. How so with the seed, with the skin, put it in a blender. Take the Kerala, wash it with the seed, with the skin, with the seed and skin. You can't take off the seeds and blend the Kerala. Blend it, this much Kerala, with water, plain water, and have it in room temperature, not hot water. Okay. See, I use hot water Kerala when I am working with inflammation or bloating or BP. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to diabetes, you need to have room temperature water and almost this one size of Kerala. And this will vary from person to person depending on your figure size. This is the maximum Kerala you can drink.
Mm.
Okay.
It's directly.
Yeah, you can. So generally, I add half a glass of water to this much Kerala and gulp it off. General. The other way to nullify the taste is to combine it with amla. Okay. So what I do is take two nalakai or two amla and one Kerala, this much Kerala, blend it in a blender, mix water into it and drink it off. Initially when people start drinking, they can't gulp the pulp. Okay. So you might like to strain and drink for first 10-12 days. See, zeher zeher ko kaatta hai types. The bitterness of karwa and the pungent taste of amla practically goes away when you combine Kerala and amla together.
Okay.
So it works very well for people with diabetes, even if it is a hot climate, even if you are a pitta body. If you drink it just once a day, suppose if you are working, because you have to drink this fresh and you can't carry it to office, you might like to do it just end of the day before you go to sleep. Kerala, either just basic Kerala juice or Kerala and amla combined together, blend it and drink it off. It will help you in terms of reducing bloating, better digestion and reduce the sugar levels. But avoid Kerala tablets. They are useless. Avoid Kerala powder. Avoid the ready-made Kerala juices in the market. They are useless. Even if you make Kerala juice and keep it in the fridge, you will see the taste is completely different in the evening and it becomes acidic in nature. So, because it will get fermented. Any juice which you keep till evening, whether it is any fruit juice, vegetable juice, it will get fermented and it will lose its nutrient content. So, please blend it fresh and drink it off. It works better. Now, green tea. If you have diabetes, you might like to have green tea post lunch. Okay, I've seen with many patients that after having rice, they have green tea within 15 minutes of finishing their lunch. It does allow them a good digestion. It allows in terms of reducing their sugar levels. But avoid drinking green tea alone. Like suppose it is just 11 in the morning and you want to drink off green tea, don't do that if you have diabetes. Okay. If you want to drink green tea, have it post lunch, post dinner, not after breakfast, post lunch and post dinner. Okay. That too, 15 minutes, within 15 minutes of finishing your food. Okay. Suppose you have become 25 minutes or 30 minutes.
Okay.
Skip the green tea. Okay. Don't have green tea because it will create constipation and acidity in the diabetic people. Okay, now Chitrana and Palya, okay, they work very well as a combination to reduce sugar levels. Okay, most of the time when people are looking to reduce diabetes with me, I do ask them to have Puliyo Grey or lemon rice or Wangi Bhat or Bisivele Bhat or raw mango rice or tamarind rice. When you combine it with Palya and have, it improves your digestion and it makes it easier for you to digest the rice. Okay. The safest time to have rice, if you want to have white rice, normal rice. See, again, aisa nahi hai ki brown rice is very good for health or red rice is very good for health. It also goes with the place. Like in Karnataka, we are Sona Masuri rice people. And if you have somebody who have had Sona Masuri all your life, it will suit you. It works good for you. Okay. So if it's time to have rice is lunch, if you are looking to have red rice with ghee, sambar, do it in lunch. Okay. It will help you to reduce the gas acidity, bloating, and it will bring down the cravings also because it will make you stay full for a very long time. Okay. If you're skeptical to eat rice, then try Chitrana. Okay, pongal, bisivele bhat. The combination of spices help. Anytime. It can be breakfast, it can be lunch, it can be dinner. There are times I give 3 times rice to people when they are looking to reduce diabetes with me. I get cases with 400, 500 diabetes. and they want to eat rice. That time, there are times I make them have pongal in breakfast, lemon rice and beetroot palya, or you know, something in lunch. Basic palya and rice work very well together. Even rasam rice work very well together. It's so easy to digest.
Most and people, when they want to, when they get diagnosed with diabetes, first thing they do is they skip rice. And they think that is
pure sugar. Because they can't eat by lunch on time. See, it takes a lot of effort and time to explain people. Hmm. Okay. It's very easy to say avoid than sitting and giving explanation. Having a time discipline is extremely difficult in India. We genetically are not people who can be on time. Okay. Hmm. So when I'm sitting on people's head, the reason I'm sitting on people's head and scolding them is because I'm trying to make them be on time. So when people are trying to work diabetes or something with me, they know that main chillane wali hu agar 2 baje lunch hua. So mere dar ke mare hi log 1 baje 1.5 baje tak kha lete hain. And then you see that sugar level is down. Eventually, slowly they start understanding. See, if you want to eat rice, eat by 1:30. There is no if, no, and but to it. Okay. And the funny part is, people are okay to eat bread in India, biscuit in India, but they are not okay to eat rice.
That is also okay.
True. It's like, see, biscuit has more glucose into it than actually the rice having in glucose into it. Okay. Yeah. Plus, even bread has a lot of sugar into it. So compared to eating bread sandwich, it is better to eat pongal. And when canteen will always have idli, it will always have dosa, it will have avlaki. Always there. It's better to eat fresh food, fresh carbohydrate, than going for a carbohydrate which is having a shelf life of 10 days. Okay. So if you have diabetes and you want to eat carbohydrate, then eat fresh carbohydrate. It will reduce the diabetes. It is not going to spike it up. But the worst part is, most diabetes people will end up having two digestive biscuits with chai or coffee. And I'm like, that is where I get the you are not judging the biscuit, but you're judging the rice. Like, that is so wrong at many levels. Why do you have a fresh food when you are, and they will be okay to have buns, they will be okay to have samosa, they will okay to have puff, but they will judge the rice. Okay. So that is a very upsetting part. And I'm like, you didn't judge that maida, and you ended up eating that maida, which is going to take a longer time in your body to digest and spike up your glucose level. But you're touching the rice, which takes 45 minutes to digest. Any rice, I mean, red rice still takes 2.5 hours. Brown rice takes 2 hours or 1.5 hours, depending on the digestion capacity. But Sona Masuri, Basmati, they average as 1 hour digestion time. 1.5 maximum. Okay. Why to judge the rice when you are not judging other food? Okay, so if you are trying to have rice and you are trying to be in a non-controversial zone, please have your rice by 7:30 in the evening. Your sugar level is not going to spike up next day. Okay, you can combine with Karela juice afterwards. O as a blood group is a born lactose and gluten intolerant. Okay, there is a website called www.dadamo.com. I'm not having the book with me here.
Okay.
Dr. Peterson Dadamo wrote a book called Eat Right for Your Blood Type. Okay, the website has a lot of information on it in terms of how blood groups and diets work. Okay, blood group makes a huge difference when it comes to consumption. Who has a blood group is somebody who can't digest a lot of wheat. Okay, and they feel bloated, they feel gastric, and it doesn't help their sugar levels. Okay, so if you are O as a blood group, you might like to shift to bajra or jawar rotis, okay, or do chitrana or idli dosa as a dinner, then instead of going for wheat. Wheat is overrated in India. Like, India is a milk drinking, wheat eating, chapati eating country, where we prefer chapati before everything. See, chapati became popular, or wheat became popular when wheat started getting sold in 5 kg packets in the market. Before that, wheat was never marketed and wheat was not the king in the market. There are too many things which you can have. Kodu millet, tinai rice. They work really well if they are taken in lunch. Okay. So you might like to try out different food by reading about your blood group. Okay. For B positive, B as a blood group is a chapati eating blood group. So they digest chapati very well, whether it is B positive or negative. But for O as a blood group, wheat creates a lot of other issues in terms of, like, you will see whiteheads or pimples coming on hand or back or thighs. Okay. At the same time, it makes people bloated. So you might like to read about your blood group. Fifth point is intermittent fasting. See, if you are doing intermittent fasting and you are having breakfast at 10 o'clock, having dinner at 4:35, and post that you're not having anything, and if you have diabetes, okay, please make sure to have fruits or vegetables or both at 1 o'clock during the lunchtime. Okay. See, when you have diabetes, it is not advisable to stay empty for a very long time. Okay. So kuch nahi to basic, whatever. See, the palya we make in Karnataka, they are not very spicy. They can be had just like that. You don't even need rice or any carbohydrate to complement it. So if you just have 1 cup of vegetables and 1 cup of fruits in lunch, and then have your dinner at 4:35, at least you will avoid the gas acidity. The moment there is a gas or there is an acidity, your sugar level will spike up. Okay, there is a book called Fasting Can Save Your Life. This is something which we use for teaching people how to fast. Like in naturopathy, we are very big in terms of fasting. We do water fast, we do fruit fast, we do vegetable fast, we do juices fast. So there are ways to do fasting in different medical conditions. Okay. So before you start doing fasting, read thoroughly how you can fast. Okay. And prefer to read books than actually reading the websites. Because somebody who's giving something in writing, their credibility is a bigger issue than somebody who's posting a video. They can turn it off from the internet and there is nobody who will take a responsibility of it. So, see, do read the book. It is very good in terms of learning how to fast in India. And it does cover in terms of intermittent fasting, what are the different ways you can do with different medical practices. Last is how to eat fruits in diabetes. Okay. Since the fructomine level goes up and it's a concern or worry, and this is a season to eat mango and jackfruit and watermelon. Okay. So anything which tastes sweet in nature as a sweet fruit, you can do it by 12 in the afternoon. Okay. So somebody who's not 12 in the afternoon, suppose you are eating normal, you are having breakfast, you are having lunch, you are having dinner, like a normal human being and not a fasting. Okay. That time you're looking to have fruits. Then you can do fruits by 12 in the afternoon in terms of glucose food or sugar fruits, jackfruit, mango, watermelon, muskmelon. You can definitely have them by 12 in the afternoon. Okay. But not in the evening. Evenings are good to have citrus fruits. Okay. So 5 o'clock is a good time for having citrus fruits like guava or apple or mosambi, oranges, kiwi. They can be easily had at 5 in the evening. But post 6 o'clock, avoid fruits completely if you have glucose or diabetes. If you sleep by 9 o'clock, you can have fruits. First of all, if somebody is sleeping by 9 o'clock, they are not going to have diabetes. Okay. They're not going to have diabetes. And if you're sleeping by 11 o'clock, you still have diabetes. Okay. If you sleep by 1 o'clock, then 200% of having a glucose level, which is high. Okay. So if you are somebody who sleeps at 12:31 and you're finishing dinner at 7:30, cucumber, tomato, salads are your go-to food, or drinking buttermilk is a go-to food if you get hungry at night. But avoid having fruits at night if you have diabetes. And avoid having junk at night if you have diabetes. Okay. Like, people will have chips at 11 o'clock and then they will blame the rice next day.
I had rice.
That is so not done. See, in diabetes, now the digestion is the key. If you digest, your sugar level is normal. If you don't digest, your sugar level spikes up. So have anything sweet. Suppose you are looking even to have sweets. Cakes or mousses have by 12 in the afternoon. Okay, at least it will give full day to digest. And you can control what you want to eat. Like there are times I do meet people who have diabetes and they're addicted to chocolates. Or if they feel very low. See, craving for sweet comes when you are not having enough support or love in life. Okay, this can be a resentment towards parents. There can be a lot of issues. See, with people who have diabetes, they're extremely emotional in nature, and psychologically, they do think that people don't understand them. That's the basic thought process which triggers diabetes eventually. In those cases, it's please have your, and there are people who are continuously monitoring their carbohydrates so that their glucose level don't spike up. So if you have sweet in the morning, come to a practice of eating sweets in the morning, you can practically control the food intake rest of the day. Lastly, idli dosa is your friend. Okay. Fermented is your friend. Okay. If you have diabetes and you are late, it is 8:39 at night, and you have a high uric acid. Suppose there are people with high uric acid where protein level shoots up, and if they eat dal at night, there are times it might shoot up pain, uric acid, gout pain. Okay, in those cases, idli dosa is your friend. Okay, that 99 dosa with different vegetables work out very well. Nothing. There are days I have, you know, there are days I have aloo bhindi also with diet dosa. Okay. You can eat anything with dosa. So, and it's 100 calorie. It's very easy to digest. And it is not going to spike up your glucose levels. Okay. So, dosa works. Idli works. If you are late at night and it's 10 o'clock and you have diabetes, you're looking to have dinner, please have vegetables and dosa idli. It works very well.
So this is probably the reverse kind of interview that anybody expects from a diabetes topic. Usually when you go to diabetes, people say avoid this, avoid that. The entire discussion is about what you can avoid and what you should do. Here, Atri has a set of things that you can eat with timings. So even said you can eat cake, you can eat sweet fruits, you can eat whatever you want. But if you do it right in terms of timing as well as in terms of quantities, she is the person to go to. So what Atri believes is that you can change the way your body behaves, and your health and psychology and emotions can be controlled by the type of food you eat and the type of care you take about getting things digested on time. So if you want to know more details, Atri runs a blog called Revise Diet, and she's available on WhatsApp for consultation. Thank you, Atri, for joining and explaining and taking time on your busy day.
Thank you for the opportunity.
You're welcome. We'll look at other one more video, probably talking about cravings and how to fight them next time. Until next time, have a good day. Thank you.
Bye.